Raji, I can see Raji. Can you put Raji on the line, please?
Appa, 2:30 we have tongue session for Sydney.
Yes, just 2 minutes. I'll take only 2 minutes. Put Raji on the line.
मम्मी
मंडल I was talking in tongues, brother. Don't worry. He understands my tongues. Raji, are you there?
Yes, Papa.
Okay. Now, I remember I was in Kenya.
Yes.
Okay. With brother Prashant.
Yes, Papa.
And you are on the bed with your spine all gone.
Yes, Papa.
Correct? And when I asked you, you said, Papa, I'm on the bed. I can't move. Okay. And I began to explain to you, woman, thou art loosed.
Yes.
And I told your brother, I want the video because what's going to happen is going to be amazing. And
Yes.
your brother was ready with the video. And
Yes.
brother Prashant started to sing that song.
Woman, thou art
In the name of Jesus, you are loose now with the guitar. One line. And we went on and on and on. And we were both on fire for God. Okay. We were there. After 20 minutes, we stopped.
Yes.
And I said, Raji, how are you? And she said, Papa, I'm out of the bed and I'm dancing. Okay. So I said, okay, you got all the video. When I come to India, I want the video. She said, yes. And then she told the brother, have you got the video? And he forgot that he was a cameraman. He was looking at his sister and he got so engrossed in what was happening before his eyes that he got frozen. He forgot that he's a cameraman. He forgot that he should shoot take the video and everything.
Yeah.
Okay, my question to you is, from that day till today, did you get that pain again?
No.
When a rhema word comes, you will never have that pain again. Now, my question to you, in 1 year, how many times do I call you? Might be one or twice. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Why is it that from Kenya I made that call? Did I know?
No.
So why did God put in my heart to make a call?
So that I can hear the voice of God.
See, a person who is not calling you for a year, hardly once or twice, right from Kenya, I have to call you.
Yeah.
That's how the kingdom of God works.
Amen.
You get in your spirit when you're sensitive. Pick up the phone, call. Now, and that person over there is ready. The season is right. Bang, finished. And you were all wet in your clothes, sweating and sweating and sweating. How many years back it was?
Yes.
This was before you got married?
Before I got married, so 2010, 10 years.
So 10 years, and that pain has never come back.
Nothing.
Husband, sorry, you did not know this secret. You came to know today. Hallelujah. Your wife's chassis was bent. The Lord made it race straight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Okay. So what, how does a person build his house on the rock? When he spends quality time with the Lord and begins to hear his voice. And that's why Jesus answered and said to Peter. In other words, when Peter spoke those words, he himself did not know from where it came. Now, see, when Francis was talking about Teresa, they both have not met and this thing. And I'm thinking, Goa, beach. See how it starts. Beach. On the beach, shells easily found. Delhi, stones easily found. Now, how do I put it? And God puts in my heart. Shells are so easy, but diamonds are found. You have to dig. To get a rhema word, you have to dig into the heart of God through the scriptures. And now, when you get the rhema word, everything has changed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
before the break, there was Raji there, right?
Yes.
And she got a healing. Now, just because she got a healing, does that mean she got cleaned up? No.
No.
She also got married. She also had gone with her package, thinking it's going to be tuku-tuku. And he came with his package, tuku-tuku. Now, what happened to both tuku-tuku? Friction after friction. Friction after friction. Friction after friction. Raji, can I share?
Yes.
Get Raji now. Because let's learn the... Yeah. Get your husband also.
Sister, you're on. Yeah.
Papa, I'll get him. 1 minute. He's sleeping.
Wake him up and bring him. This is so good, no, that you can go to everybody's house, knock at the door and say, come on, you are on the hot spot. Anytime. you know why? If you are seeing them smiling right now, I'll tell you, I think not even a year back, there was a tragedy. And the reason I'm calling these people is, I'm calling those people who are broken, who are shattered, and it looked like the game is over. And the reason I'm calling them is because that testimony will give hope to those who have already made a decision that I also want to end up this situation. Yeah, Raji, come on, put her on the video.
Yeah. Yes, Papa.
Where is he?
He's here.
Yes, good evening.
Are you sleeping, man, when I'm talking? now you know Jude, what is happening in each person's house.
Now taking shift.
The Holy Spirit knows whom to pick up at the right time. Okay, I'm not going to your past story, okay?
Okay.
Fast forward, you are in the Lord, you are in the ministry, you are growing, you are this and that, and then you started, you thought, I'll get married to this boy. Okay.
Yeah.
He's handsome, he's built, broad shoulders, all that you wanted is there. Praise God. Now, when you got married, he was also in the Lord, right?
Yes.
He was also doing some ministry work, right?
Yes, very much active in church activities.
Like Jude.
Yeah, same. Brother Jude, testimony.
But no word of God.
No.
So you felt that this is good, that he is doing the Lord's work. So you already jumped to the conclusion, he's the best person. Anyway, he's doing God's work.
Yeah.
After that, what happened?
After that, it was totally different, Papa. It was like what I had learned and what he was doing was totally different. It was like, oh my God.
You're not working in the church?
Working in the church, but what we learned was like to work on faith, to activate our faith. And there it was like totally on theology and the theories of the churches.
Okay.
So it was not matching to what I had learned.
Okay. So every day was friction.
Yeah. Every day it was friction and every
but
day.
But you had learned not to do the friction, no?
I was keeping my mouth shut.
Okay. How long?
Till my elder son was born, just for a year.
Okay, then?
But then Bombay life already come into us, right? That thing is already there, oh, train wala practice and all. So, okay. It started triggering up, little.
Then?
One side it was like, no, I should not open my mouth. Thank you, Jesus. I'm very much, into the word. No, I will not open my mouth.
Okay.
I kept my mouth shut.
From his side. Bye. Yeah. Hello. He's thinking what all she's going to say. Now let me get a turn. Okay.
No.
Now when you got married to her, okay?
Okay.
You know that she's already doing ministry work, this, that, and you are also active in the church. Everything was beautiful. Both of you, very good Christians. Then what happened?
Slowly, slowly, the friction take place.
When you came, the data also went low. Yeah. Tell me.
Sometimes the frictions also take place in between us. That means first of all, when she came into my life and she telling about the faith, you should have to imagine first, and you should have to open the mouth, and first of all you say thankful to Jesus. I was like, "Arey, yar, tu pagal hai re."
Okay.
How can you say? So, matlab, totally, I was on my physical sense. That means, okay. So first of all, you should have to take evidence from the physical and then open your mouth and say thanks. That was my theory.
Okay.
And she was saying that if you have to see in the physical sense, and you should have to spiritual sense and say thanks.
Okay. So,
definitely, it was not matching with my principle. Mm. And she always saying the same principle. I can't ever digest it. Matlab, a lot of the times I call her, matlab, you have become mad. Nothing.
And the person who is teaching her also is mad.
Papa, in real sense,
what was his call? What was his response?
No, he was actually saying, really, वो आदमी पागल है जो तेरे को ये सब सिखाता है.
Now you see, Jude, all these people, what all reports they have about me? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, Papa.
What he was telling couldn't understand in.
Papa, many of them would have not understood Pagal now.
Pagal means okay, I understand mad.
He's mad and he's teaching you how to live your life mad.
Oh.
Yeah. Fast forward. The friction went up to what limit?
So, but lekin Papa, in between it was like every time the hints were given, like in between when I conceived, we had that news that I'm pregnant. Doctors had stated that my uterus is weak and I will be having a premature baby.
Hmm.
Every time the God was actually reminding me, and I was totally with the word and speaking the scriptures, no, God has given me this precious gift, so he knows how to take care of my baby and he's there with me. And every time I used to share the same thing with him, he's like, aisa nahi ho sakta. And you know, but then the testing time was there, totally bed rest, everything was going on like that. But after that, really amazingly, I completed totally 9 months and then I delivered my baby without pain.
And the baby was healthy.
Healthy baby.
And whatever you were speaking, whatever you were seeing with your spiritual eyes, that came to manifestation.
Yes. And
so what did this fellow say? What did your husband say?
In between, before the delivery, I should tell him that Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. Therefore, there will be no pain. And you know, it was just 10 minutes. I went into the labor room and in 10 minutes I was out and the news was there ki 10 minute mein bachcha ho gaya, and full hospital was shaken. The full hospital was packed. It was season of deliveries at that time. So he was like, "Are aisa kaisa ho sakta?" Like he was also shocked ki 10 minute mein delivery ho gaya and she had not that pain. She was already out of it. And every time the God is giving signals, this is how the faith is, but then to healne ke liye taiyar hi nahi hai. Like he's like, nah, it's not possible. It was okay. Like that.
Then when did the friction start?
Friction
go to the peak?
As you know that I was working in Bombay and always out on work, working. So I couldn't stay at home. And after getting married, I had to be at home. Totally in four walls, char diwar ke andar hai, with the baby. So he used to go out for work. This fellow, Sajis coming home, he never used to ask me, "Are what you did the whole day? What happened? Alle lele, kuku kuku." That was nothing. And it was like soon after the marriage, I got conceived, and that husband-wife relationship, kya hota wo, that we were just learning. So, but that thing, he never asked me, "Are tu kya, what you did, how was the baby, kya hua, kya."
And that started, you know, giving me thoughts. Why he's behaving like this? Why can't he be sensitive a little bit? And all such things. So we, so the things, the friction started from that time onwards.
And how long did it last?
It lasts till 2018.
For how many years?
It's like 2014 onwards, 4 years.
Okay. So what was the outcome now? What was the plan going on in both your minds? Now the friction was very, very terrible that it was like both of you can't even see each other.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it was like totally, that time also I messaged you and I said, Papa, now I can't take this up. Now
I remember. Yeah.
Yeah. So even one day he also said, bas ho gaya, now even do what you want to do. Now I will also sign the papers.
Then how come the change took place?
I hope you remember when I spoke to you about this, we had sown a seed and we prayed over this and we said, yes, we believe that. Now I, at that time I was at, first of all, I want to admit it today is like, I had a pride in myself saying that, are, I know the word of God. I know what a thing was there in me. Yes. Then I can do it. Was there. My God ko bola tum rest karo and I'll take care of it. That was my attitude. Yes. But then when I spoke to you and we sowed the seed, I said, now is the time for me to keep my mouth shut. And every time, just whatever I had spoken, I cancelled everything in the name of Jesus. I started speaking only the things which I wanted to speak. Yeah.
Now you start
reading. Actually, brother, so yesterday, day before yesterday, Jocelyn also teaching that even one seed entered to our mind, it will make a big forest. Okay. The lies will increase and it devils keeps it big, to a big forest. The same way, so once she entered the thought that he is not listening to me and he is not taking care of me, and it became a big forest in her mind. Okay, and she started to take into the action. That means she started to murmuring and she started to using against us, against me. And what was my point? I was behaving as a boxing bag. How much punch you can do? There is nothing. There is no any changes in me. How much you can do. I don't have any time.
So you are not attacking her back, but like a punching bag, taking all the punches.
How much you can do? It was her murmuring was my food. I become stronger and stronger.
He's saying that I will not ready to change at all.
Yeah.
I will not change. You can't change my life.
Okay. So you became more stubborn and she became more champion in murmuring and grumbling.
Yes, the same way. At the meantime,
by now you reach the point that I want to, what you bring the papers, I'll sign it. Enough is enough.
Yes.
Okay. Now when did the U-turn took place?
And in between there is also company also closed out and there is a big financial crunch in our family life. And finally, we decided.
When there is no money, the marriage still goes smooth, no?
Yes.
When the husband was bringing the money, okay, and still he was getting grumbling and murmuring. Now when the husband company is gone and he's not bringing the money, that means she will be treating you very nicely.
you understood it very well.
because of finances, do you know, when the finances get into a mess, the fight can go to extreme level. Because see, there are sometimes a person can get married thinking that he has got a good job. Okay, So the foundation of the marriage is, he's got a good job. But everything that you got is temporary.
Yes.
Now when your company closed down, the money stopped coming and all that, and the grumbling is there, everything is there, and you're not even bringing money home, and you're sitting at home. Now when you're sitting at home and she's grumbling, the heat must be like a diamond heat.
Yes.
Then what happened?
Then finally we decided that Raji will go to Mumbai and she will start some work at Mumbai only. Mm-hmm. And in between there is one plan came to us, that means she will shift to Dubai also. And that was the extreme peak level at Dubai period. Mm-hmm. Each and every night, matlab there will be some fight we will start, and I will go on bird at extreme negative energy level. Okay. Mm-hmm. At the same on the next day, I will also start the day with that negative energy.
Okay.
That means that shout will continues at will till up to two days, yeah, to 1.5 day, 2 day. Matlab there is no any phone call, there will not be any messages, and nothing will be there. Okay. And finally, I don't know ki matlab to once she attended the retreat at Dubai also, at that time. And unfortunately I had also get one thought to attend one retreat in Mumbai, Goa.
Unfortunately,
it is extremely unfortunately. I can say unfortunately. There was no any plan. One night I also get a thought that you go and attend one meeting in Goa.
Okay.
And that was the time that retreat was for on marriages.
Okay. February. And he came for that retreat.
And he was there for that retreat.
And he was all alone.
All alone.
Yeah, all alone.
And where were you? I'm in Dubai listening to the retreat on YouTube live in Dubai, and he was sitting in Goa right in the first bench.
Yeah, I know. now, Sanjeev, what made you come right on the first bench when you were sitting right behind?
No, not right behind. I was sitting in the second row, and Raji said to me that I want to see you in the first row. Okay. Okay, yaar. Matlab if you want evidence, then I will sit on the first row only. And what she said, matlab in first row, from the middle, you should have to sit in first, second, or third chair. Matlab at least. Matlab I can see you in the camera angle. That means.
but between that also, before I could go to Bombay or go to Dubai. The thing was like, he never stopped. But when we saw the seed and I understood my mistake, I repented and I kept my mouth shut and I started, I gave the battle to the Lord. And whenever he used to come, you know, like to punch me with his words, I used to be like, making curry or something, doing some work in the kitchen. I used to be like, all my fleshes are fighting as if they're screaming. To bowl now, why you're keeping your mouth shut? You go back and save. You are a champion in that. You go back. And still I'm like, no, thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Love you, Jesus. I know Christ is in me. Love you, Jesus. That still that thing is going on. And when he told me that he's going to Goa and he's already booked the ticket, and I didn't believe him, because I told him I want to see your ticket first, that you're going to but then that thing came, why you're being a carnal mind. So what I did, you know, I with my roommates, we went to a cake shop over there in Dubai near our house. And we bought a cake, and actually I started rejoicing by faith. Yes, he's bought the ticket. He's sitting at the first bench in the same place where I told him, and he's sitting, and we started rejoicing in faith. And then the next moment, he's sending me the photo that, yes, I am already in the retreat house, and I could see him on the YouTube live that he's sitting there.
So what you dreamt in faith by bringing the cake and celebrating that he's sitting in front. So once he is there, he will understand the principles and he'll come back a changed person.
Oh, seed just so, yeah, the seed which is sown, I know that job is already done. So
no, there is also one testimony, brother. Even at the first day, we taken the topic of unforgiven servant, parable of unforgiven servant. That parable taken there. Message, I don't know, it completely touched my heart. मतलब तो I क्या बोलते हैं कि मतलब एकदम I feel that I am that servant, that unforgiven servant. That I am that servant that when God given all this love pour upon me, and I am that person that never pass on that love to anyone, even though. And at that day, on the second day, we learned one theory that whenever you came into the emotional situation for the emotional time, you should have to talk to the emotion, that is because you are the king, not the emotion. When the emotion become the king, you will be the slave for the emotion. At that time we learned one theory that whenever you came into the situation, that you should have to open your mouth and talk to the emotion, that emotion, get out from my body. Because I am the king, you are not the king. And you will obey what I will say, and I will say according to the word of God. So you should have to get out from me right now.
Interesting. So, go ahead. Preach.
that thing, it is really interesting one for me. And at that night, it almost at 11:30 at 12 o'clock, our sessions completed. And I went to the bed, and I did call to Raji also on WhatsApp. Somewhere. So at that time, what happened? My cousin brother was also there. And when I started to call to Raji, at the same moment, he messaged he also want to talk to. So my emotion triggered out. All this day I did not talk to her, or I have a word with her. Now I want to talk to you, and you are saying that please wait. After 30 minutes, after 40 minutes, I will come to you. I will reply to you. That emotion.
Who Raji saying?
Raji behaving like that. That triggered my emotion at the peak level. I become completely anger, and at the same moment I realize that all these 2 days I learned about how to control my emotion, and this will we should not have to allow the emotion to control over us. Then I come into one decision that no, today I have not opened my mouth. Even whatever she do, I never opened my mouth. At that night, there was a complete battle is going upper side. Retreat center, dormitory side.
You're getting drained because the thought is so strong. Take the phone.
Devil is screaming, literally screaming in my mind, literally screaming. That, hey, come on, yeah, open your mouth and fire. So I am not going to open.
Put the video on. Go ahead, tell me.
Yes, devil literally saying that fire, why in all those days you always reply to her, and always you reply to her, but that is, why you should shut up your mouth and stand up, open, come on, kick. No. Devil, no, I am not going to open.
This is happening at 1 o'clock at night on the bed. This is happening at 1 o'clock at night. Then?
Yes. So 3 minutes there was a tremendous fight. I opened my mouth and said, "Hey, emotion, no, I am not going to, I am not your slave, and I am the king. Get out from my body. After the 3 minutes, na, the battle won. The first day, that means I am the winner. I feel, yeah, I am the winner. And later, look, and at that day, I sleep very well, very well. And the next day morning, around 5 o'clock, I wake up and get ready. And even I went to a workshop for have tea. Okay. I don't know. From the morning, I am bubbling with the joy. I can't even control my body, control myself. That means how much bubbling that coming, joy that coming out. Because I am the first time I killed the Goliath. I killed the... because at that day, I feel that, yeah, I am the David. I killed the Goliath. That means I won the battle against my emotion. And I can't believe at that day, almost 30 persons came to me. And they even say directly to me, "Hey, brother, good morning, God bless you, how are you?" With smile. Are so I become very bad. Why these people, even I, even don't say any, even not talk any one word, even from the last day, I never talked to them. And they coming up to me and saying that, "Brother, hey, good morning, praise Jesus, hallelujah, good morning." At that time...
So you mean to say all these days, nothing was happening, nobody was wishing you. The moment the joy came, people just came and began to wish you.
Yes. Okay, that means at that time, I feel that I am the hero, I am the Salman then.
Then...
because the fans directly coming to me for the autograph.
Then?
Yeah.
This was the first time in your life you experienced anything like this.
Yes.
And you got the taste of it.
Absolutely, yes.
You got the taste of it.
Yes, I got that taste.
Then?
Then I started to realize, why these people are coming to me? What difference take place in me? At that time, I realized that, yeah, because yesterday night, I won that battle. I had filled up with the joy and the peace. And that same peace that coming up to me and coming to my face, and that is passing on to the other people also. That is why they also be happy. That means a positive energy started to passing from me.
Praise God. From
my body.
Praise God.
Yes. That was the first experience, brother. That was the first experience. I am the hero.
Now the whole retreat, you are sitting there writing notes and everything.
Yes.
Then, now the retreat got over, and then when was the reconciliation?
Reconciliation was like when I told him nothing worked out for me in Dubai, even though trying for many jobs over there. So I asked him only one thing: if I don't get a job and I come back, what next? The only thing which he told me is like, "Don't worry, God is there for us. You come back, we have a big ministry for us over here in Gujarat."
And that is that he has never spoken in his lifetime like that.
Kabhi nahi, never in his life. And I was like, what to do? I was jumping or I was dancing. I don't know what to say and what to do.
That this man who was never believing is now believing for all these things, and he just said, "You come back home."
Yeah, no, and under, I was like, welcome to our family. This is what I was telling you from almost 6 to 7 years before.
Now, brother, one thing, literally from the last 2 days, one thing I realized very well, that first, she already told you that once she had had the feeling of the pride that I can do very well, I can handle it. God, Lord, you rest. And she started to grumbling on his side. That means that was the, and at that time devil started to putting lies on her mind.
Correct.
Once she surrendered at Dubai, at the same moment the Holy Spirit also started to talk to me that you should have to go and attend the retreat in Goa. That means two days before you also telling me that you one person have to anger on that rock, then that she can change the other one out.
Yes, exactly. Because before getting married, she had a good job with a good salary and all, high position and all that. She said, I can get a job in no time.
Yes.
That pride took over, and now she found that she is not getting any job. She's not getting anything. So what was her pride had to die. And when she came to Dubai, she tried everywhere, everything.
Yes.
And now when nothing clicked, she came to realize, I am nothing.
Nothing.
A failure. Lord, now I turn to you. Please help me. That was the turning point.
Yes, that was the turning point. She did not open her mouth to me, but at the same time, I don't know, she had the touch. And once she said to me that, Saji, you also have to go to go and attend the meeting. Even I did not committed to her. That means, I will go. No, I just only so told that, let's see. But at that, when once she got committed to Lord and she put her anger in that rock, at that same moment, the life changed. Even he turned me also. That was the big thing.
So now how is the life?
On even brother, once I came to go, matlab home na. Once she came to Gujarat, okay. Once I learned a lesson from there. Mm. Even one person become anger or any other emotion under the control of any emotion. Mm. That means the devil putting lies on her and he taking the control over that person, right?
Yeah, correct.
Okay, so after we reaching to home, Gujarat, when she became anger, na, I felt laughing. I just watching to her and I started to laugh. I literally seeing the devil on her face. That means I am in mind, I am saying, hey, devil, you taken the control of her body, na? She lost. Big look, devil is on her face. Literally, I started to laugh. Finally, she opened her mouth. What? Whatever I say, you never going to listen me, and you always keep laughing. What, yeah? Always you laughing there. I seriously say something, you keeping laughing. Oh, Raji, I am not laughing to you. I am laughing to devil, that I can see the devil on your face.
That will flare her even more.
Yeah.
No, Papa. It was like I started keeping my mouth shut.
Then how did you start getting adjusted? Because when he's saying, I can see the devil on your face.
Even I started smiling back. I said, okay, fine. I'm getting under control of something else which is not from the kingdom of God.
So he became an empire to tell you to cross the boundary.
Yeah, and it's vice versa, Papa. It's the same for him also. Whenever he's triggered up with something, even if he's talking to customers, or even if he's talking with our children, the same thing. I just have to say, Saji, which kingdom you belong to? Automatically, everything is down.
And we all learn to be sensitive, to point out to one another. You have just from one
So always we started to help.
So Sanjeev, how is your life now with each other?
अरे ब्रदर कांट से एनीथिंग देयर इज नो एनी वर्ड इट्स अमेजिंग इट्स अमेजिंग इट्स अमेजिंग
पापा आई हैड मैसेज्ड यू लास्ट
होल्ड ऑन संजीव संजीव इन दुबई व्हेन शी वेंट
या
जस्ट बिफोर दैट द प्लान्स वर आई एम रेडी टू साइन द पेपर्स
हां
या आई कांट हैंडल इट इट्स इनफ ओके And after coming, you found another secret that when you see the devil on a face, you start laughing and give a wild laugh.
Yes, yes. Matlab, the beautiful weapon. Whenever someone get anger, na just start to laugh.
So the person will get more angry.
Yes. Yes.
And then how will that person get cooled?
No, if there is not getting any response from some other side, na, the person will come at the extreme level after she dropped all the weapon.
I did not know this.
New generation, Papa.
peak, and then she neutralizes and comes down.
Yes,
it is like no fuel in the tank.
Otherwise, the other person will run out from that place.
So instead of running, you keep on laughing. Raji, when you did the first time, what was your reaction?
About
when he started to laugh. What was your reaction?
Then I thought ki actually I'm becoming a fool, I'm becoming a slave. So I better change my route and come back to the track. Actually, it was like, you know, I was feeling like my train is out of my track. So whenever any one of us are out of the track, only thing what we do is like we laugh to each other or we give a sign of, you know, some signal that yes, something is going wrong, so we better be on track. So only weapon we use is like a smile or a laugh. That's it. Till now, with the word of God.
And now we learned one other word from Anand that changed your focus.
Yeah. Sorry. Come back again.
From Anand Growth Retreat.
From Anand Growth Retreat, I learned one other lesson, one other word, change your focus. Sometime, even Raji or me, open our mouth and start to grumbling, become angry. The other person comes and just say, change your focus.
So this diamond went to pressure. This diamond went through the fire. Okay.
Yes, yes.
But you both discovered for your marriage that laughter is the medicine.
Yes.
Not fighting back, but laughing and giving an
indication. Laughing is the best medicine.
And that, you know, you give the other partner a hint that you are in the carnal stage, change and come back into the spiritual stage.
Yes, beautiful. Yes, yes.
So what about the children now? Children are also laughing? I said, are the children also laughing now?
Passing the same
bar. They are also starting the same tool. Look. I can say one thing, when she came to Gujarat, she came to Gujarat and she is trying to get a job in the previous school as a teacher, and at that time there was tremendous financial crunch also there. Once she went to school, that was the first day that they finalizing her salary also and everything, and from the previous night my son started vomiting and had having loose motion to him. And from the previous night it started, and he become very weak. And I can say even in my purse there is only 10 rupees is there, even not complete 100 rupees. Even I want to take him to any doctor, I should have at least 500 rupees to pay the fees and take the medicine. Okay.
Correct.
And she went to school, and she told me that, yeah, Saji, you should have to take him to any doctor and take medicine for him. But I know the truth that in my purse there is no any money.
Correct.
But at the meanwhile, I have the faith that there is nothing on my body of my son, and Jesus is with me, and he is the body of Christ. There is no any sickness, there is no any virus on his body, and this body is completely controlled under the by the Jesus. So he become healed. There is no any sickness, there is no any virus. Okay, I had that faith. And she, whenever she came from the school, na, actually, what was her expectation? The principal or the secretary said much lower salary than her expectation. And you know, whenever the expectation will drop down, na, the devil will comes into our mind and put the seed. Really. Matlab, she completely under depression, disappointment. When once she entered into the house, and she saw that I am working on the laptop, and my son is lying on that bed, and he not even can stand up. Matlab, there is no any power on her body, health. Okay, correct. She started to grumbling, and she started to firing on me. firing on me ki matlab to she completely started firing on me. Hey, you never take any you did not taken my baby to hospital and did not taken any medicine for him, and you go, this is my bangle, and you can sell it and take money and take him to hospital. At that time I completely realized that she is not operating under the hello.
Yeah, I'm listening, brother.
Yeah, she is not under the power of Jesus. The devil is operating on her. She is under the control of devil. I completely realized it. And even I did not open one any single word. And I stood up from there, and I came to her. I talked to Raji. Raji, I believe that my son is completely fine, and there is no any issue on his body, and he is completely healthy. Okay, then why you are grumbling? No, she grumbling. And at that moment I told to her, come on, just sit and we will pray. At that same moment we started to go to the we went to the bedroom and hold hands each other, and we started pray. After the pray, yeah,
what did you all say?
We prayed that Ian is the body of Christ, and Satan's sickness has no power, no place over him. Christ has redeemed Ian from the curse of the law. Therefore, every sickness or disease that comes upon his body dies instantly in the name of. We started confessing the scriptures. We started praying together, holding the hand. Wow. And at that, it was just 10-15 minutes maximum. And at that time, that son, our son, who used to only drink a sip of water, he used to vomit, or he used to just throw it up by motions or by vomiting. So after that 15 minutes, he drank a half bottle of water, and he didn't vomit, neither he go to the washroom, nothing. He was feeling energetic, and he said, "Mama, I want to eat something." From that time onwards, Ian was completely set free.
Yes,
God. Even he get down from the bed, na, he take the bottle and he drank almost half liter water in one stretch. At that particular moment, his body his loose motion and his vomiting completely sealed by the blood of Jesus, and he completely healed. Okay. That is the one incident that we practicing ourselves in our family, that how can we take the war against the sickness. Okay. And the next day, my daughter also started to
show the same symptom,
started vomiting, started diarrhea, loose motion and everything. At that time, we discussed that, look, the devil trying to take her in his control, and he trying to war against us. Now, in the other end, matlab my son become healed, and there is one other link is there, that is daughter. He started taking war by her body.
Correct.
At that moment, we started to pray for her. Okay, pray for her.
Same prayer.
We holding our hands each other and we started pray. After the prayer, she went to toilet. Okay, that the amazing thing there is that she went to toilet.
No, the thing is, like, in the morning they went for the mass and I was with the baby at home. So she came up and she said, "Mama, I want to have some milk." And I am telling her, "No, beta, you don't drink milk because you will be vomiting or you will have loose motion. So don't drink milk." And she's telling me, "Mama, you told that I am the body of Christ and Satan has no power over me. Satan's sickness has..." She's just 4 years old. So she's telling, "Mama, I'm body of Christ. I'm set free in the name of Jesus. I'm healed in the name of Jesus. Give me the milk now." This is what my baby is telling me. And I am telling her, don't drink, because otherwise you will vomit or you will have loose motion. She had that milk and I was just praising. I said, "Okay, fine. The child is teaching me. This is what the faith is. I used to teach them. Now they are teaching me back." So then she went to the washroom, she passed the motion, and she's literally what I was really, I mean, I never knew that she's in the washroom. So when I went over there to search for her, she's sitting in that washroom and she's talking to the loose motion. "You loose motion, get out of my body right now in the name of Jesus. Can you listen to me? In the name of Jesus, get out of my body right now. Papa, I don't know what to do. I just came. I took my phone." And she's telling, "Mama," she's very much fond of music and all. "Mama, put Jesus song. And she in the toilet, she's singing the song over there, God is good all the time. I am here in the hall dancing, with listening to that song. And when she came back in, just half an hour's time, she was all back with her strength, everything normal. We didn't go to the doctor, nothing. Nothing we did. Praise God. That was really, actually, before going out of the house, we started practicing it in our house.
Praise God. Now, does Sanjeev like me?
Yes.
He loves you.
even I am at the peak level, matlab even I give matlab meet you directly na, I will give one chummeshri chumma.
What he meant is, when he saw me physically, the first thing he did was he caught me tight and gave me plenty of kisses. Praise God. God can turn it around when we focus on the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So please, with all that we studied, just write down this, please. You got 15 minutes more. Come on, let's write it down.
Yeah.
We will never obtain God kind of marriage. We will never obtain God kind of marriage. Simply simply by going along with the crowd, by going along with the crowd, going along with the crowd, doing what everybody else does, doing what everybody else does, we have to dig deep. We have to dig deep into the heart of God, into the heart of God, to discover his principles, to discover his principles. Praise God. As I was sharing with Teresa and Francis the other day, that shells, you can get it on the shore. You don't get diamonds on the shore. You got to go and dig it. There's a hard labor. In the same way, whatever has got true value, you will never find it lying down on the top of the ground. The good stuff is always found deep down, where you have to work really hard to get to it. Praise God. In the same way, a good marriage, okay, we have to work at it. Praise God. It does not happen by accident. There are many a times people will say, please pray for my marriage. Let's say the person is praying for your marriage and you are still living a carnal thinking attitude. Will your marriage ever change? Will things ever change?
No.
The reason your marriage is in crisis is because you are of a carnal thinking. This could have been avoided long time back if Sanjeev had to listen to the spiritual part. But he was so fixed on his carnal thinking, and the thing began to increase that when he became carnal, the person who was spiritual also became extreme carnal by complaining and grumbling. So was there a need to change? Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So write down, marriage is a God-ordained institution. Marriage is a God-ordained institution. A lifelong relationship between one man and one woman, between one man and one woman, over time and under the heat and pressures of life, over time and under the heat and pressure of life, two people under the covenant of marriage come together and are lost in each other to the point where it becomes impossible, to tell where one leaves off and the other begins. You can put it as an example what Sanjeev went through that night, where the wife said, give me 40 minutes, I will come back to you, or 30 minutes, I'll come back to you. And that's when it was looking like, this is the last thing I did. I came for the retreat. I did everything. But you lady, you're not ready to change. You're not ready to respect me. You're not ready to honor me. You want to talk to your cousin. Your cousin is bigger than me. And all these thoughts running. And he had to practice what he had learned. One is forgiveness. And secondly, you are a king above all your emotions, all your thoughts. So you can command it to leave and it shall leave you. Praise God.
Praise God.
So once he understood that and he got that first battle of his life, a spiritual battle fought with spiritual weapon, he experienced the joy. And that battle was somewhere around 1 o'clock, 1:30 at night. Praise God. From the next morning, he began to practice what he had learned. And that practice began his journey in his marriage. Praise God. So write down, marriage is a process. Marriage is a process. A fusion of two distinct and different elements, of two distinct and different elements into one. A sparkling jewel of love. Faithfulness. And commitment. That shines brightly. In a world. Which is fading away. So once Sanjeev found it, did he have to practice it? Come on. And the more he began to practice it, did it make an effect on him? He found the formula. Praise God.